the Kushan Empire expanded from Bactrian lands into China and India. Kushan Empire started after Kujalak Phraates executed other four kings of Ujjayi Confederation in 30 AD. Kujalak Phraates expanded the kingdom until Kabul and also conquered some part of Indo-Parthians. However, Kujala died around 80 AD when he was 8 years old. The Kushans expanded the south into the region traditionally known as Gandhara. The successor of Kujalak Phraates, Vimatakto, was capable of expanding the kingdom till Mathura in the south and to some extent in the northeast as well. Vimatakto appointed the generals to supervise Indus realms, which strengthened their power and capable of expanding the kingdom further. Kushan Empire seized the lands of India, which covered the large area, therefore double the size of the empire. Vimalakirti Phraates, the successor of Vimatakto, ascended the throne in 100 AD and was capable of expanding the kingdom till North Indian lands and also seized some of the kingdoms between Indus and Ganges rivers. Art and archaeology of Kushan Empire flourished between 1st and 4th century CE. Though there were silver and copper inscriptions already, gold and coinage started in Kushan Empire. Vimalakirti Phraates was the first to introduce gold and coinage in India. Deities were imprinted on the golden coins. Mahasena on the coin of Vikshan, Oisha on a coin, Oisha on a bull, etc. Kushans were also great in the art. The Buddha in Gandhara style on a coin of Kanishka I. Statue of Harithi from Gandhara. Dynastic statue of Kanishka with inscription. Image of Naga between two Nagis inscribed during 8th emperor of Kanishka. Naga statue with inscription from the reign of Vikshan.
At the height of the dynasty, the Kushans loosely ruled a territory that extended to the Aral Sea through the present-day Uzbekistan, Afghanistan and Pakistan into northern India. They had diplomatic contacts with the Roman Empire, Sasanid Persia, Aksumite Empire and Han China. The rule of the Kushans linked the seagoing trade of the Indian Ocean with the commerce of the Silk Road through the long civilized Indus Valley, while providing security that encouraged travel across the Kundera Pass. The loose unity and comparative peace of such a vast expanse encouraged long distance trade, brought Chinese silks to Rome, and created strings of flourishing urban centers. The Kushans had been predominantly Zoroastrian and later Buddhist. From the time of Vimatakto, many Kushans started adopting aspects of Indian culture. The first great Kushan emperor, Vima Kadphises, may have embraced Shaivism, as surmised by the coins minted during the period. The Kushan emperors who followed represented a wide variety of faiths, including Zoroastrianism, Buddhism, and possibly Shaivism. Kanishka has earned renown in Buddhist tradition for having convened a great Buddhist council in Kashmir. Kanishka also had an original Gandhari vernacular or Prakrit and Buddhist texts translated into the language of Sanskrit. Along with the Indian emperors Ashoka and Harshavardhana and the Indo-Greek king Menander I, Buddhism considers Kanishka as its greatest benefactors.
The decline of Kushan Empire. Vasudeva I was the last great Kushan emperor. As we all know, for all great things, there is an end. So, in the case of Kushan Empire, after the death of Emperor Vasudeva I in 225 CE, the Kushan Empire split into western and eastern halves. The western Kushans, located in Afghanistan, were soon conquered by the Persian Sasanid Empire. In 248 CE, they were defeated again by the Persians, who deposed the Western dynasty and replaced them with Persian vassals known as the Indo-Sassanids or Kushan Shahs. The Eastern Kushan Kingdom was based in the Punjab. Around 270 CE, their territories on the Gangetic Plain became independent under the local dynasties such as Yadheyas. In the mid 4th century, they were subjugated by the Gupta Empire under the great Samudragupta. The last of the Kushan and Sasanian kingdoms were eventually overwhelmed by the Hephthalites, another Indo-European people from the north. Considered as one of the five of Yuezhi Confederation, Kushana Empire has its own page in the great book of history. It was flourished under the great rulers like Kujala, Kanishka and Vasudeva I. They represented a wide variety of faiths including Buddhism, Zoroastrianism and Shaivism. The rule of the Kushanas linked the seagoing trade of Indian Ocean with the commerce of Silk Road through the long civilized Indus Valley. They played a key role in spreading the wings of Buddhism, and coins was one of the prominent cultures of Kushana Empire.